Hello and welcome to From This Corner TV. We've got another great show for you today. I do want to remind you that our program is not just to entertain you, but to talk about topics that both interest you and educate you. And I'm Marilyn Dayton, your host and producer, and we've got Dodie is back as our co-host.
Yay!
So let me ask you this. Have you ever wondered what raw food is? Yes, raw food. We hear it a lot nowadays. And why would you want to eat it? Doesn't really sound all that great, does it? I don't know. Well, we're going to find out today because our guest today can tell you all about it. And she's known for raw foods for vibrant living. I love that. She is Joanne Rajo Raya, a certified raw food chef, teacher, and coach. All you got to do is think of Rajo, okay, and that's her. You can Google that, you'll find her. So she teaches, helps, and inspires busy on the go, health conscious people, that's us, how to incorporate raw, fresh, plant-based food, very good stuff, into your everyday lives, making healthy food choices without feeling overwhelmed, thank heavens, and spend less time preparing your meals. Doesn't that sound great? So get out your pen and paper. You're gonna wanna write a lot of things down, okay? So, Jo, welcome to the show.
Thank you, Marilyn. Happy to be here.
I'm so glad I finally got you here.
Yes.
We've been talking about it for a while. So let's start with this term, raw food. What is that?
Raw food is, now this is vegan, so we're talking nuts, seeds, fruits, and vegetables, and a few other things to season with spices and that sort of thing. That's raw food. To take it a step further, there's something called living food. You've seen in the markets, you've probably seen sprouted nuts or seeds, this sort of thing. And that's from soaking these nuts and seeds. Mm-hmm. And that's going to release the enzyme inhibitors, but also allow it to get to the next stage, which is sprouting. So that's what they call it, living foods, but it's really sprouted food.
It's okay. Like a plant starting to grow.
Exactly.
Right. And that's where a lot of the good energy is.
Yes,
right?
Absolutely.
Okay.
Yeah.
I read somewhere about enzymes, since you're kind of mentioning that at the moment. There's something about not heating the food above a certain temperature, 115 degrees, is that right?
It's a little controversial. Some say 112,
some
say 118. So there's this 112 to 118.
So keep it under 112 and you'll be fine.
Right.
Yeah.
Well, under 118.
Under 118. Between 118
and 118. Oh, yeah. Don't go any higher than 118.
She's a math major, people. Okay. Keep that in mind.
No, don't heat it any more than 112.
Right. And most of our stoves, or not stoves, but our ovens, heat higher than that. So they have dehydrators on the market that I think they start at 95 and can go up to 120 something.
So it's just that real warming thing. Yeah.
Right. It's pulling the water out and drying whatever it is you're putting in, whether it's a vegetable or a nut or seed, and it's just pulling all that water out.
And what is that temperature? If you go above 118 or 112, whatever whatever the magic number is, what happens that's not good?
It's supposedly when you go above 118, that the nutrients or you're killing the nutrients that are in there once you go above 118, and then there's going to be less beneficial.
Okay.
From it, but it's all good. You're eating nuts and seeds, fruits and vegetables. So
nuts and seeds, fruits. So no grains, nuts, seeds, fruits, vegetables.
There's grains. Okay. I just don't go in that direction.
Sure.
For grains, a part of what I do is I show everyone how they can incorporate raw food, not all or nothing.
Yeah.
So for my grains, I love quinoa. So I'll have, that's one of my heated, cooked foods that I have. Mm-hmm. And most of the time I'm doing 50 to about 75% raw.
Mm-hmm.
So I do have that, brown rice, this kind of thing.
Yeah,
so,
okay.
But you can sprout grains, I just don't.
Okay, I'm just thinking, let's see, no chicken, no fish, no eggs, no dairy.
Right.
Technically. And if you want to go perfect.
Gluten-free, no dairy, no yeast. Yeah.
So let me just touch on quinoa here
for
a second. What is that exactly? I mean, it looks like it could be rice. It looks like it could be a pasta. What is it?
Well, just like rice, rice comes from, I don't know what country it really originated from, but same sort of thing. It's considered an ancient grain. There's a group of ancient grains. Quinoa is in there, amaranth, something called teff, which most people probably never heard of, but it's really tiny and it has a lot of calcium in it. These are all, they all fall in the ancient grains, and a lot of them are from... not sure exactly the country, but I believe Africa, somewhere over there. So yeah, they've been around for a long time.
Wow. I don't know why, but for a while I thought quinoa was a nut. You know, a baby little nut, teeny tiny little nut.
Kind of reminds me of bulgur wheat. I mean, you soak it and it kind of opens up a little and no?
Well, I don't soak it. I just, you take...
Make it like rice?
Make it like rice. You just double the liquid and you cook it the
cook
same
it.
Way.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
So many people today are very health conscious, which is a wonderful trend, and I hope it continues, and I hope it spreads further as time goes by. But let's talk about the benefits of raw food and why it's so important to us.
Okay, so I'll tell you my experience with my benefits. First of all, I had more energy.
Oh, I like
and,
that.
Yeah, that's good.
Yeah.
I had this overall good feeling. I just felt lighter, and I noticed that I didn't have this kind of fogginess in my head. My head, my brain, my mind was very clear, mental clarity.
Mm-hmm.
Energy, stamina, I just felt like with some of the other foods, I was more weighed down, just felt heavier.
Yeah.
But today, everyone's always looking for a little more energy and, you know, boost their day that way, so.
Well, we all live such stressful lives today. And we tend to eat on the run, which is a bad thing, I know. And with something like this, you can have things prepared and ready to go, so you don't have a reason to grab something that's heavy and going to weigh you down, cloud your brain, and all of that kind of thing, right?
Right. Oh, absolutely. I know for me, I have a lot of vegetables throughout the day. I try to have a vegetable even for breakfast. I'll just saute some, well, of course there's the smoothie, the green smoothie.
Yeah,
but
which we'll get to.
Yes, we will. But sometimes I'll just saute some greens to have alongside whatever I'm having for breakfast. There's chia seed puddings, there's oatmeal. Some people will want to have eggs with their sauteed greens, but something as simple as that. But even avocado, have some avocado.
I love
avocado.
I do too. I do too.
I had some yesterday with my eggs for breakfast.
So good.
And then I had avocado for lunch too. But I mean, I love it.
Don't
they say? I mean, I've heard we should have something green with every meal. Is that?
I like to have something green with every meal. Then I know that I'm getting my greens in for the day.
Mm-hmm.
And then if you have different greens at each meal,
then
you're getting a wider variety of nutrients from all those grains.
And then they eat the colors, right? Like the vegetables, reds and yellows and oranges. You're getting all the different nutrients from the different colored vegetables too. I was thinking maybe we could rewind this a little bit and go back to when your career was in software. You were a techie.
Right.
And now you're here. And so you went from techie to here.
To kitchen.
I don't think you just jumped from one place to the other. So you want to give us a chronology? How did you get into this?
So, it's my whole life I've always had allergies and hay fevers and I don't know. Ear infection, all kinds of things throughout my life. And then as I got older, teenage years, 20s, fast forward, it just got to be where I developed food allergies.
Mm.
And so that was really hard.
Mm-hmm.
And I've always been involved with, I always loved cooking. I always liked preparing meals. And my mother was Greek, my father Italian.
Nice
so
combo.
I come from a household where we're always
having good food.
And I just naturally gravitated to wanting to like prepare foods and make wonderful spreads and meals. And so that's always been with me my whole life. So whether I was in software or not, I just loved talk to some of my coworkers about food. What did you bring for lunch?
And no, you're not going to eat that, really?
Right. Yeah. And then fast forward to leading up to today or now, it got to the point where I couldn't really eat anything without being sick, actually.
Wow.
Just discomforts, distress, what have you, headaches, all kinds of things. And then I was working with a naturopath who introduced me to some juice drinks, juicing. So I started that and really felt great and was curious about, well, raw food. What else is involved in raw food? That's how it all started. And I just loved it so much, I wanted to share it. So then I sought out how I can get certified and be official, a raw food educator, teacher, chef, and all that. And the rest is history, as they say.
Yes, it is. Now, you did spend some time at Whole Foods.
I did.
Learning even more on the job, so to speak.
That's good research,
Right, yes. Yeah, so I was at Whole Foods for a couple of years, 2010 to 2012. And I was in the whole body department. And each department in that store would have demos, so I always loved doing the demos, and they usually had me do the demos, and it involved some raw packaged food and some not, but really healthy things. So that was fun, and I did learn quite a bit. They would have the vendors come in and educate you on the products, the ingredients, you know, and why you need to have certain supplements and things like that.
Yeah, because if you're eliminating certain like protein, the group that's commonly called protein, the meats and fish and stuff, you have to figure out how to get that the right proteins from this more limited amounts of or types of food, right? So were they teaching you that? I mean, how to get combine foods to get the right proteins or?
Not necessarily, but I knew that anyway. It was more about promoting certain products. So the protein supplements, then there was, you know, there's all kinds of superfoods out there. You see those green powders that will have the spirulina and they'll have the wheatgrass and some of these other, they're really, really rich, dark green, full of minerals and all kinds of things. That kind of stuff.
And the thing is, you don't, I'm sure our audience is sitting there going, wait a minute, are you telling me I have to completely change my diet right away, now, tomorrow?
No.
I got to throw everything away and go out to this, you know, a Whole Food store or something like that and get all of these things, and they don't have to do that, do they?
No, they don't.
How would you recommend, like, you know, you got somebody that's eating, you know, fast foods and restaurants and just choosing whatever, and now you want to get them to go from there to a more healthy, if you will, okay, and because, you know, you're going to turn some people off by going, okay, eliminate all this and go for that. So how would you suggest somebody kind of starts, you know, transitions, you know, without getting all afraid and throwing their hands up in the air and going, I'm not doing this.
Well, the quickest and easiest way is to include a green smoothie. And you can do that the night before. It's not a big deal. You just throw it all in the blender, even put it in your to-go cup. And then when you wake up in the morning, instead of pressing the button for the coffee or the tea, just grab your...
Oh, wait. Coffee's not
in. Well, you can still have coffee.
That's it. I'm done.
I'm not policing any of it. I don't police it. As I said, it's not all or nothing.
She said to go. You can have your coffee, then you can grab your green tea.
Coffee first, then your green smoothie.
You have to remember, it's not 100% or zero.
Right.
And I think that if people understand that and they even just incorporate more vegetables and more fruits.
Exactly.
They're in the right direction. Right?
Exactly. I mean, yeah. that whatever works for you, it could be, all right, I'm going to start to have one piece of fruit with each meal, or maybe after I eat, or whatever it might be, or a green, you know. Okay, maybe there's people out there that don't eat a lot of greens, so having one serving greens is a big deal.
Right. Yeah.
So let's have that be the goal.
Right.
Right? So just start small and then work up to, you know, increasing your goals.
And I've been starting gradually. You would be so proud of me, Dodie. I am. she knows I'm a chocoholic, okay? I can't help that. But that's a different story. What I'm talking about is... I know, and we're going to get to that second half.
Yeah.
I've had that before, and it's like, oh, my God. I have started changing things. I've got an order in for a really, really good meal replacement, you know, that kind of thing. And I asked a lot of my friends, like Janet Verney and some other people, and so, and I've got a green smoothie stuff coming. Well, you know, the basic, and then you can add to it if you want to, and that kind of thing. So I'm taking the giant leap, and... for like lunch, instead of like throwing together something, you know, I have been opening the refrigerator, which is, you know, a big thing. Not the pantry, for a prepared something. Open the refrigerator and say, let's see, what's left over in here? I can put something together. So I'll take some chicken, and then I'll take some green spinach, and I'll take an orange. And I'll go, oh, this is going to be so good. And I'll use the orange as my dessert.
Exactly.
You know, just kind of suck
Baby.
On the... Yeah, I know. And it's... I do feel lighter. You're right about that part. Because prepared food, of course, is bad for you anyway, and it does make you feel heavy.
Well, and your body... the additives they put in those
foods.
Oh,
and not only that, but you should hear my stomach. Oh, my God. It's very distracting, you know, when my stomach is going, even my dog goes, what's that? And that's from the wrong foods.
Yeah.
So let's talk about our guts, okay? And what a lot of us suffer from, which is like candida.
Oh, yeah. I just went through a period of what is going on, why is this happening. I was getting intestinal distress, and we all go through this, so it's okay to talk about it, but I was getting in that kind of thing, and where it was starting to interfere with my everyday life, okay, and some discomfort in my bloating and discomfort in my stomach, and I went online and I did some research. I didn't even think about candida, and you and I were talking about this before the show.
Yes.
And so I got some supplements that were supposed to help, probiotics to help with the digestion and all of that, and I stopped all the other things I was eating, that like supplements, and because I think the combination of too many different weird things, whatever. But it's a lot better now, and I've been trying to stay cleaner with food as well, and I've been buying like, you know, the non-GMO, no hormones, no da-da-da-da-da chicken, and when I first started trying to do that, I was finding the difference between regular boneless chicken breasts and the clean version was like $2 a pound, $2.50 a pound, to $7, $8 a pound. I'm like, I'm on a budget here. You know, I want to be careful. But I managed to find a store that every 4 to 6 weeks has an incredible sale on clean chicken. And I go and I buy like tons of it. And I have it in the freezer. I maybe we should talk a little bit about what do you feel about frozen foods? Because some people think, oh, all the nutrition's lost. But I think sometimes it's better than the processed stuff.
Oh, I agree.
You know,
I agree.
So, but anyway, so that's, for me, that's progress that I've managed to figure that part out, okay? Which also then brings me, I think we should talk about the gut part first and then go to the budget first.
Yeah, let's get back to gut.
Yeah, let's get to the gut part first. And your experience with candida and the overgrowth of yeast, because it never occurred to me that that was what was going on, and it's quite possibly what it was.
It's fairly common.
And people don't talk about it because they're embarrassed.
No.
And some people don't even know that they might have that going on.
Right.
But I sought out different holistic doctors and naturopaths and different people, and I kept getting the same answer, candida. So
wow.
So it's hard to really know. Well, just because you feel bloated doesn't mean you have candida.
Right.
You really need to seek out a professional advice on that.
What is candida? I mean, you know, our audience is going, they're talking about something. I've heard of it, but I don't know what it is. What is it?
So in our gut flora, we have a certain amount of yeast in there, which is fine. But what happens is sometimes it can grow and get out of control. And then that's when things start to break down. And, you know, maybe you get, I don't know, some sort of allergy. It could be a food allergy, or maybe you have... It goes beyond the seasonal allergy, and it's different for everybody. It's really hard to really pinpoint. That's why I say it's hard to know, well, do I have it? So, but for the gut, it's just yeast overgrowth. And I guess when you can't, if you can't eat food and it's bothering your gut or your stomach, then that means there's something going on, right?
And you have to go find out what it is.
Right, exactly.
Now, probiotics help with that, right?
Yes, they do.
So I take a probiotic every day.
Yeah, so do I. Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah, those are great. So probiotics populate the good bacteria that's in our gut, so that way they can fight all that bad bacteria that's in there.
Yeah. Well, when you back off to the foods you're suggesting,
then
your body is in, I think, a more alkaline state, which is where it should be.
Yes.
See, I drink a lot of coffee, so I throw myself into the acidic part, and that may be what was aggravating what was going on for me. But this kind of a diet is perfect to get your body into that alkaline state, which is where it's supposed to be.
Right. Yes.
So you want to talk about alkaline versus acidic?
Right. There's all kinds of resources and books and things that will tell you these foods are alkaline and these are acidic. But... really, if you eat fruits and vegetables, for the most part, I mean, of course you can like have too many acidic plant-based foods. I mean, that can be true too.
Mm-hmm.
But
like what, tomato maybe or something?
And that's the funny thing. People think that if a food seems acidic when they're looking at it or what they know about it, they think that that's how it will appear in their body. But for instance, citrus, lemons, as an example, they become alkaline in the body.
That's crazy, right?
Yeah.
And you don't really have.
Lemon water is really great.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
But there's such a list. I can't be quizzed on which foods.
Yeah, it's better to do
just refer to, but but the more vegetables you have, the better off. I mean, you're going to have more alkaline type of body going on than if you didn't.
Sure.
So,
And for our audience, just to let them know, cancer loves acidity in your body.
Oh, yes.
Okay.
Yes.
So when we're talking about, is it better to be alkaline versus acidic? Alkaline. Okay.
Absolutely.
And you can research it everywhere.
Mm-hmm. Right.
But it's important to keep your body alkaline. There are also these little test kits that you can get. You gave me one once, and I found out, I'm very acidic here. I have to make changes. Mm-hmm. You can fight cancer, or you can even keep it from developing if your body is more on the alkaline.
Because it's stronger, to fight anything off. Sure,
right.
And
right.
The cancer goes, I don't want to be here. I'm going bye. So that's a good thing.
Right. That's where the greens come in. It's really great to have those greens.
Yeah. And a lot of people think, I need to detox all the time. And I've also heard detox by season. If you eat like this. Okay, wonderful raw foods, and every once in a while, you know, you throw in a good piece of meat or, you know, that kind of thing, and you're really smart and you stick to it, you don't have to worry about detoxing, really, do you?
I don't think so. I mean,
it wouldn't seem like it.
As the seasons change, they say to, you know, maybe eat cleaner at least.
Mm-hmm.
That can be a form of detoxing your body from some of the heavy foods that you're having all winter long. But you see clean food, clean eating everywhere, and I think that the closer you get to that, the better off you'll feel, and it will be really good.
Yeah. 'Cause some people, I've had people on the show that say, you know, detox is good for you. Every season, get out all the crap.
Well, it's true.
Well, the thing is, you know, if you're eating a lot of the foods out there, then yeah, you got a lot of crap you got to get rid of.
Right.
But and then I've had people on the show that said detoxing, actually you're losing some of the good things too. You're not just getting rid of, you know, the toxins in your body. There's others that are escaping with it. So the best thing is try to keep the toxins away as much as possible.
Right. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, just eat clean, drink clean water, you know, everything that you can,
yeah. Yes.
and not dairy milk. Okay, coconut milk, almond milk,
delicious.
All of those,
yeah.
And that's coconut milk. I love coconut milk. So yes, much better for
okay.
you. Okay, are we biased? Yes, we are, but it's good for you.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah. So, do we need to go to break soon?
Not yet.
Okay. So we started on this conversation about how to go from where you are.
Yes.
You know, you're eating out at fast food places, or your kids are, you know, they have to get to soccer practice, and so you're grabbing things on the run. How do you get from there, like, habit-wise, I guess? Mm-hmm. You know, how do you change those habits? And financially, budget-wise, because some of this food can be sort of expensive. Maybe fruits, vegetables, nuts and grain, and
Nuts and seeds?
Seeds, okay.
Yes.
Maybe they're not that expensive when you compare it to meat and things. Maybe not, you know, but...
Well, it can be expensive, or it can not fit a lot of people's budgets. I do a lot of organic, just because I don't want the pesticides.
Sure.
So you have all that kind of thing. And there's some foods that are less, the Dirty Dozen or the Clean 15. They have those lists out that tell you, like, for instance, strawberries. I always get organic strawberries, just because the pesticides just really hold on onto that fruit. But anyway, to answer your question about what they can do is the big thing, just like in any other meals that they're doing, is you have to plan your meals, plan ahead.
Mm-hmm.
Planning ahead is really the big thing. The example I gave about the green smoothie, that's one way to do it.
Right.
As far as where can you go get these foods, not at the regular supermarket, they may not even be on sale, but I like to go online. Some people like to touch and feel their food and see what the package looks like. So in that case, wholesale clubs are great.
Really?
Costco has a great organic line, yes.
Oh, wow.
Yes.
See, now I would have never in a million years guessed
really?
That.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Yeah, yeah.
No, I would just think all a lot of more packaged stuff, but they have produce? They have,
yes.
See,
they do.
I would have never guessed that.
You know, We're in spring. We're going to get into summer soon, right? And so, of course, there's the farmers markets. Those aren't going to be necessarily be cheaper, but it's fresher.
Fresher.
Mm-hmm. There's something called community supported agriculture, CSAs.
Oh, yes.
So you get a bag of produce. You show up. You get a bag of produce, and
once a week you pick up your produce or something.
There's some kind of fee. There's food co-ops. I know in Willimantic, there's the Willimantic Food Co-op. It's a storefront. But most of them deliver to a certain location, and everybody has already figured out what they ordered and all that. But anyway, those are some things.
Sure.
I do catch things on sale, like at Stop and Shop or some other markets. I look at what's on sale, and I may not need it that week, but I might need it next month.
Right.
Depending on what the item is, of course. It can't be produce.
So that makes me think about, once again, frozen.
Yes, I go there all the time
like
with vegetables.
Frozen, like
organic.
For instance, making a smoothie. Sometimes you pull out a frozen bag of, you know, blueberries.
I do that.
Something.
Yes.
Yeah. It's not that much different,
no.
Right?
Right. Right. Yeah. It isn't. It's for frozen food. I have the frozen fruit. I don't have so much frozen veggies. I do like my fresh. I could, but that's a good example that you just gave with the frozen fruit into the green smoothie, because in the winter we can't get fresh berries that are really good.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
And you can buy frozen organic.
Yes, you can.
Yeah, so yes. Now you're staying even cleaner,
yes,
right?
Yes,
yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, and cleaner, yeah. And and people like today, they like, oh, handy, I want it right now.
Yes.
Instant gratification. Yeah. And if you've got it in the freezer, and you can make things and freeze them.
Yes,
right?
You can. With raw food, there's some things that don't take very well for freezing. I have a lot of success with the desserts that I make, because a lot of the desserts are nut-based, so they freeze okay. But there's some things that just don't freeze. Mm-hmm. But anything that I've come across that I've made that's raw, usually it can last a good 4 days. So, I mean, that's a good part of the week.
Yeah. Oh, yeah,
so
absolutely.
You can use it in a variety of ways.
Sure.
Yeah.
And I have found, too, that the healthier I eat, the less hungry I am. I don't need as much to fill me up. Mm-hmm. Because, you know, when you're eating heavy foods, and you eat and you feel heavy, and then it starts digesting, you go, wait a minute, I feel hungry again. Because that heaviness is abating, and you're going, oh, it's starting to feel empty again. But if you eat well, good, clean, healthy foods, it's really interesting.
Yes.
That, I mean, you can have a smoothie that's filling. I mean, they're very filling, and they're very good. My grandkids make their own smoothies every day.
Oh, that's
my
great.
Grandson, he'll come out into the kitchen.
Yeah,
I know.
Those
I know. My 14-year-old grandson comes out in the kitchen and he says, "I'm thirsty." I say, "Okay," and so he reaches for his smoothie.
That's great.
That's what he'd rather have that than water. He'll drink water, but he's thirsty, he drinks his smoothie because he loves it.
Oh, that's wonderful.
And it's good for him.
That's wonderful.
Yeah.
Wow.
I know.
Yes,
so
me too.
Am I. So am I. Well, it's just about time to take a break. And as you have noticed, we have a few things here on the table. What we're going to be doing on the second half is we're going to be tasting some of the very wonderful things that Raw Jo has brought us today. And she's going to tell you what it is that we're tasting, and you will see us react to it right away, immediately. And we will share with you what we think. And it smells so good. So, hey, stay tuned. Keep your pen and paper handy, because in the second half, you may want to take some more notes. So we'll be right back.
You always made sure I brushed my teeth.
You told me that smart was cool.
You always told me to dream big.
To all of those parents who took the time to make raising their children their most important job, we'd like to say,
thank you.
Thank you.
From the bottom of my heart, thanks, Mom and Dad.
This message is brought to you by the U.S. Air Force.
If you keep tanning, indoors or out, the effects of harmful rays will show up on your skin. Wrinkles, age spots, and an increased risk of melanoma. The second most common cancer in women 15 to 29. Stop tanning. Time may not be on your side. Learn how to protect your skin at spotskincancer.org. A message from the American Academy of Dermatology.
You'd do anything to take care of that spot on your lawn. So why not take care of that spot on your skin? If you're a man over 50, you're in the group most likely to develop skin cancer, including melanoma, the cancer that kills one person every hour. Check your skin for suspicious or changing spots. Go to spotskincancer.org to find out what to look for. A message from the American Academy of Dermatology.
Oh, hey, bud. Where are you headed?
I'm just gonna hang out.
With Gary and Todd?
Yeah.
I've been meaning to ask you, is there any drinking going on in this crowd?
No.
If any of your buddies ever pressure you to take a drink, just tell them you promised your dad you wouldn't.
I'd do anything to keep you safe.
Okay, I will.
I hope this is working.
I promise. Love you too, Dad.
They really do hear you. For tips on what to say, visit underagedrinking.samhsa.gov.
Closer.
Oh, okay. Hey, we're back. Hello, hello. We are talking with Rajo today, and we are preparing her delicious, delightful samples that we're going to be enjoying. And we've been talking about what raw food is. Now you can see what it looks like, and it doesn't look what you think. It doesn't look like what you think it's going to look like. So we're back, and I, yes, I saw you make this, and I, tell us about this wonderful looking cheesecake.
You're going to start with dessert? Aren't you going to start with the breakfast smoothie?
Which okay.
She's just dying to get into that dessert, right?
Oh, you want to go backwards?
Let's go backwards.
Okay.
I could do that.
Let's go backwards.
Okay. So this is the cheesecake. This is the raw cheesecake. It's considered the New York style version.
Okay. And you said raw cheesecake. Is that what you just said?
I did. Okay. It hasn't been cooked. So the crust right here, all that is just almonds, dates, and sea salt in the food processor. And then when it gets sticky, you can press it into the spring form pan, just like that, in like minutes. Yes,
that's
very
so
good.
Cool.
And the filling, cashews.
Yes.
Coconut oil, lemon juice, and there's a little maple syrup in there. So not 100% raw, because maple syrup, you know, is cooked, but that's okay.
Yes, that's true. Now,
is
white.
Is this your recipe?
Yes, it is.
Yeah. So what we're looking at
on
is
the website.
Yes,
okay. It's on the website. Yep, everything that you see here and here, and there's a lot more on the website. But I saw her video when she was making this, and you said that the cashews, what did you do to them to prepare them?
Oh, I soaked them overnight.
And why did you do that?
Mostly to make them soft, but when you soak the nuts and the seeds, as I said before, they release the enzyme inhibitor. So if we wanted to have more than one slice of cheesecake, we could, and our stomachs would be just as happy.
Oh, I know that. Yay!
Love cheesecake.
Wonderful. Uh-huh. So do I. Yeah. But the thing is, I have a dairy problem, so regular cheesecake.
Yeah, but there's none in there.
And
none
in
this.
Yeah. That's why
I
think you should cut this.
That's right.
And it looks delightful and wonderful.
Oh, yes.
Now, this is when our audience wants to be right here with us.
Yes. Yes, absolutely.
Okay.
Thank you.
You're welcome. And then, would you like raspberry sauce on top?
Raspberry sauce? Yes, I would love it, please.
It's just a bag of frozen raspberries with maple syrup.
Blended in.
Yes, it's
wonderful. Yep. Now, you come up with these recipes yourself, right?
Well, not all.
No?
Oh, boy.
That's okay.
Not
Don't
all
worry
of them.
About it.
Not all of them are mine. But there's so many recipes out there, whether it's my website or somebody else's. But, you know, it's interesting because you've seen one cheesecake. You've seen really a lot of them because they're all similar. They all use the similar ingredients. But, yes, it's quite good.
This is just beautiful. Where's my phone? I'm going to take a picture while you're cutting a piece for Tony. And then we will put this on Facebook, of course, later and say this is what
you ate. Did you want the raspberry sauce?
Sure.
You should see this. It looks like real cheesecake.
Perfect.
Okay, I gotta check out here.
Will you join us?
You've probably had it a million times.
We'll
I just need a plate. Maybe in a few minutes.
Okay.
Yeah. So tell us more about some of the desserts that you make. I know you make wonderful desserts with raw food.
Well, there's brownies. Brownies are really easy. Once again, usually you're using walnuts with cacao powder.
Mm-hmm.
A little dates, food processor, sea salt, and then it gets sticky that you can press it into a pan.
Right.
And then usually spring form is the best pan to use, only because you can actually get the dessert or the food item out. Otherwise,
that's kind of important.
Just a little.
And it's nice because they have spring form pans that are actual rectangle or square. So if you want to make brownies look like squares, there you go.
Oh,
right.
Okay.
So
well, I mean, if you're doing like the regular cheesecake, the graham cracker crumb. It's done the same way. You usually don't bake the crust, do you?
No, not usually.
Oh yes, I've made a regular cheesecake for my family.
And you bake that?
Oh yeah.
Oh, do you?
Okay. It has the butter and the graham crackers and the sugar, and it needs to get like a golden brown before you add the filling.
Mm-hmm. Oh.
Yes.
Okay.
This has got a very, very good taste to it.
Thank you.
I had no, you know, I mean, I love cashews.
I'm going to use my fingers because I see there's one fork for you. So I'm going to grab this and indulge.
Go for it, Dodie.
Yeah, don't, you know. So.
Just go for it. Take a big bite. Take a big bite and enjoy. Now, see, you too can be enjoying this kind of food. Mm. You just go to Rajo's website, rajo.com, and she's got, she's got delicious recipes on there. For breakfast, lunch, dinner, whenever, right?
I don't think I would guess that this is cashews.
No, you wouldn't. Mm. You wouldn't.
I love cashews, but right. I don't know that I would say, oh, that's cashews in there. It's really good.
Yes, mm-hmm. Yes.
It's very good.
And coconut oil, lemon juice, vanilla extract,
right.
Mm-hmm. Sea salt, and then coconut or agave nectar.
Mm. I put agave in there only because there are people that still like to use that. I don't. Mm-hmm. I just use the maple syrup.
Oh, okay. Mm. Oh, you mean that's not what you used in the recipe? I mean,
right.
In your recipe.
Yeah, I used the maple syrup.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
Sometimes I take it up to another level, and I'll scrape a vanilla bean, if I have one, and I'll put vanilla bean in there instead of the vanilla extract. Mm-hmm. It does taste different in a good way.
Mm. This is just so good. I never would have thought. Cheesecake.
There's a commercial for a certain brand of ice cream, which I'm not going to mention, and they do the vanilla bean, and the kids are what's that? You know, and the kids are scraping the vanilla bean, the inside of it out, and you know, in the vanilla ice cream, you can see all the little black speckles. It's those little dots. That's mm-hmm. what
they. Right.
Yeah.
This is really quite amazing.
Oh my God, that's fabulous.
It's called the un cheesecake, really.
Yes,
because
it is.
It's un cheese. Yeah.
Un cheesecake.
But you know what? I prefer this of a regular cheesecake. Not just because of the taste. I think the taste is better. But I know my body's going to love it.
Yeah.
And I won't get the after tummy ache that I usually do with regular cheesecake.
Right.
Exactly.
Thank you.
Oh, yeah. This is great.
Okay, what else do we have here?
In the middle, we have this dip, which is it's very green. And see, nice and green?
Okay. Very green. So,
very
but
green.
It's good. We've
already tried this.
Okay, so this is the spinach avocado dip. Mm-hmm. And today we have some gluten-free crackers to have with it. You can also get carrot sticks or bell pepper or celery or anything like that if you want to use vegetables.
Sure, cucumber slices.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. So that's this particular, you could flavor it any way you like, but as you can tell, there's like a little curry, ginger, chili, right? Do you like it?
Oh, that's so good. And you know, I don't like
green. She's not a very enthusiastic person, right?
Not at all. You can't tell what I'm thinking or feeling. See, I used to think green was yucky when I was younger. Anything green, yucky. Oh, I'm not going to eat that. Mm. And here I am, sitting here going gaga over this. It is so good.
We'll share some with Dodie, too.
Yes, share some with Dodie.
I'm going to let her do her thing over there. She's having such a good time.
Oh, it's good. And I'm trying not to crunch the crackers too loud in the microphone.
Oh, yes.
So
protect the microphone, right?
Yes, protect the microphone while you're crunching. Now, we have something here that's green.
You're looking at the green smoothie.
I am looking at the green smoothie. Mm-hmm. And so, there was a time.
I'm not going to drink that.
Oh, it's so good. All right,
if
you hand me your glass, I'll get you some. So this is pineapple lime green smoothie.
Oh, yeah,
we
have a recipe for this too.
We have pineapples, obviously lime. There's a little ginger root in there, so get a little zip at the end.
I like a zip at the end.
And a banana in this too?
A banana and cilantro.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, yes.
And lime juice.
You should smell this. Oh my God, I wish we had smell-o-vision.
Yeah, the smell is nice too.
Oh, who would have thought that you could take green things, yellow things, red things, and put them all together and drink it?
We have the last one too.
Now she's got, you've got on here, pineapples are an excellent source of manganese as well as vitamin C, B1, and B6. Pineapples are also good sources of copper and dietary fiber, and they have an anti-inflammatory property. We could use that when we are starting to feel our joints and help with digestion.
Yes.
Well,
this
is my drink
fantastic.
Then.
Yeah. Mine too.
Enzymes bromelain,
so
which helps break down proteins. Good.
Yes.
God, that's all good stuff for our bodies.
It is. Right? It is. It's all good.
You know what this tastes like? I went into a, an ice cream store where they have the counter, the soda counter, and you order an ice cream malted, something whipped up together, and it tastes really super duper, not very good for you, but it's fun and it tastes good. This is like amazing. It's just amazing. And the thing is, you can make it.
So can you.
And me too. And I'm gonna. I am gonna. And it's not yucky at all. Even though it's green. It's not easy
contrary
being green.
Contrary to your childhood beliefs.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
I'm kind of like hooked more on this spinach dip, I think. Mm.
Now, there's also something else that you have. Well, now, as you know, I'm a chocoholic, so stay informed on this and get ready.
This is a special treat. This is chocolate bark. Now, this chocolate bark, I put pumpkin seeds, goji berries, and coconut on it. So if you take one out, you can see how pretty it looks. And even though it looks pretty, you can still eat it.
Oh.
Chocolate bark.
Look at that. Where are you? There. So, I don't know if you can see it, but it's got like a green thing and a red thing and chocolate.
Yes, it's quite good. So there's something called cacao butter. Cacao butter. And cacao butter makes things solidify much better than coconut oil, but you could use coconut oil too. And of course, there's cacao powder and a little vanilla.
I'll share. Temporarily.
See, I'd rather have that than this. Okay. It's the savory versus the sweet, right? There's something about that. So I think...
You're going to pass right now?
I'm going to let her have my portion. Good.
Oh, okay.
She's just so excited.
No, you got to try it, though.
I did before. I had some.
Oh, okay.
Yeah,
okay.
But she's just so excited about that chocolate.
Oh, my God.
You can take that home.
It's...
Uh-oh.
Thank you.
You've got a best friend forever now.
I am just in heaven. I am just, oh my God, I'm in heaven here. We're having fun. I hope you're enjoying watching us have fun here. And now, there's something else in your life that influenced you, your father.
Yes.
Can you tell us about that? Would you like to share that?
Sure. So, let's see. Back in 2000, my father passed away. He had ALS. And... So, he was always a strong, physically fit kind of man, loved sports and did all that kind of good stuff. And so, he came down with ALS. And one of the things that he said to me was, keep on eating those salads. So, raw food's more than just salad, though, even though, that advice was given. So,
It's, it's...
Did he have a background in nutrition, or it was an instinctive thing?
When I was growing up, we had salad with all of our dinners. Mm-hmm. So he loved salad to begin with.
Mm-hmm.
And, of course, he knew how good it was for you.
Sure,
so,
sure.
Mm.
Mm.
Yeah.
Wow, that's cool.
Mm.
That's really cool.
Yeah.
You guys keep talking. I'm eating.
Okay.
I actually was looking at some of the ingredients.
Yes.
And this one was, I think this was a carrot dip.
Okay.
That you had on your website.
All right.
And it was, the description is, you get something simple and light with such inexpensive ingredients. That's great, okay? And we talked about soaking the sunflower seeds. But I noticed this thing about, and the rest of the ingredients are carrots, dill, onion, and I'll get back to the salt in a minute. Lemon juice, olive oil, and ground pepper. But I was curious about the sea salt. Is there that much of a difference between this Himalayan or Celtic sea salt and the
Celtic?
Celtic. Sorry, or the type of salt that you would get. I went into a store and they had it in the grinder, the salt in a grinder.
You can get it that way, yes.
And I don't know. I'll have to look back and see what kind of salt it is. I'm just curious about. Because salt, I usually eliminate salt from my diet. Mm-hmm.
But that's iodized salt,
right?
Which you don't want to have. Yeah.
So you want to talk a little bit about salt here?
Right. I mean, a lot of these recipes, the sea salt that they're referring to, mm-hmm. it just brings out the flavor. I mean, just like think about baking that mm-hmm. everyone does. Mm-hmm. You have to have that salt in there, in the dry ingredients. It just I know it does something, you know, it's more of a scientific experiment when you're baking, but for this case here, mm-hmm. it makes a difference. It just pulls everything together, I guess. It makes it taste better.
Versus regular table salt.
Yeah.
Okay.
Now, as far as Himalayan mm-hmm. versus Celtic, mm-hmm. those are just two different regions where the sea salt has come from. The Himalayan, okay. isn't that the Far East somewhere in the mm-hmm. big mountains?
And it's pink.
Right. Celtic, I think, isn't that Europe? I don't even know where.
Well, Celtic exactly. is Irish.
Irish.
Irish?
Right? Irish.
Oh,
yeah.
What am I thinking? Okay, right.
Yeah.
So there's different ones. Mm-hmm. But I will tell you that with whether it's vegetarian or vegan or raw or anything like that, a lot of the recipes do call for either Himalayan or Celtic.
Specifically, yeah.
Specifically, okay. versus any other kind of salt. So a yeah. lot of them have natural minerals in them.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
So
I'll have to go back home and look in my little,
right.
yeah, what the labels say on the salt.
Exactly.
Because yeah, I don't get that specific. I usually, if I read a recipe like this and I was going to make it, I'd just use the salt right out of the cupboard. And
right.
I'm like, yeah, don't worry about it, you know.
Right.
But if there's a difference, then it's worth pursuing it, you know.
There is a difference. The Himalayan salt, I've seen like Himalayan salt lamps and that kind
oh,
of
yes.
thing.
Yeah.
And there's supposed to be some kind of benefit to it. It's kind of like, you know, I'm kind of putting it in the category of essential oils, you know, in the air around you, surrounding you mm-hmm. with beneficial things. Do you know what the benefit is of the Himalayan salt lamps and that kind of thing?
I have one, and I know that they're oh boy, I don't know how to explain it.
Do they absorb bad energy? Do they, no? Something like that?
You know, I don't know the exact
we can
answer,
Google
but...
it. We can Google it. Yes,
I have one, I use it, supposedly it makes you feel, you know, more calm.
Oh, okay.
So, yeah.
Relieves tension.
That's okay. a good thing in our stress oh,
yes,
today, right?
Yes.
I mean, yeah, because we have, in downtown Mystic, we've got a shop, spice shop, that has everything. Everything you need. Teas, I mean, just everything. And they've got the Himalayan lamps, and that's where I go to get my my spices.
Mm.
Because I know they're good spices, they're pure spices, and I don't know what I'd do without that shop, but yeah, we use sea salt only, and I use Himalayan salt, and
right.
it's pink, mm. but it's salt,
right,
and it's supposed to be really good for you.
It is.
Now I'm sure our audience is watching us, and they're saying, okay. Apparently and obviously, Jo knows what she's talking about and what she's doing. Now you can find things on her website. There's mm-hmm. smoothie recipes. There's all kinds of recipes that we've been talking about. But she also is, as we said, a teacher, and she also you coach people in changing their lives and including raw food in their lives. Right.
Right.
And so, do you list on your website, like, upcoming events and that kind of thing?
Right now, I don't have the events up there, but you can find me on Facebook where there's more information on events. I have a
okay.
business page on Facebook called Raw Jo, so that's a good place. And I have a private Facebook group, too, where there's a lot of information. But yes, there's definitely plenty of things that we can... have as far as the raw food goes.
Well, not only that, but I saw her make this cake, okay, and I saw it on Facebook and her video, and I'm drooling, you know, because it just, and she, you're going like this with adding a little bit more warm water, and I thought, but you made it so quickly,
yes.
and it was so easy.
Yes.
And it's so good.
Yeah, definitely. I'm holding back here because I don't want to look like terribly
I'm
on TV.
I'm not holding back. Well, maybe I am a little bit. What are the biggest challenges? You're helping people
right.
Understand what raw food is and how to incorporate it into their lives and that kind of thing. What are the biggest challenges that you run into with people? Because, like, you know, a lot of people don't want to change.
Right. So... what I find really interesting is that I think they're expecting it to be more complicated than it really is. So there's a few little adjustments, such as the equipment that you're using. There's a Vitamix, a food processor. Those are the two big ones. But aside from that, like once they get acclimated with the idea, oh, that's all I have to do, then there's making it a habit. But just like anything else, you just have to keep practicing.
Right.
In this case, plan ahead. And it's a matter of getting used to some of the ingredients that maybe you're not used to putting together.
Or
and they're
familiar with
and they're all. Simple. They're simple ingredients. They're easy to find. It's easy to make. And another challenge is, well, I don't know if the rest of the family is going to like this.
I was just going to ask about that.
But I don't know. But it's funny. I know the kids definitely like the sweets, but even some of them like some of these dips and spreads.
Oh, sure.
So you'd be, and of course smoothies. So it's just a matter of put it in front of them and see see what happens.
Yeah. Well, you can even I know in our household we'll have a Mediterranean night, and we'll have tonight's dinner is from Puerto Rico, and we use not unhealthy. Greasy, saucy stuff, but we do our own version. But we make it kind of fun, make your own pizza night, these kinds of things. So you could have a raw food night, only you might not want to call it that.
Right.
<'cause laughs> they'll, no.
Yeah,
and they'll look at the green and they'll go, yucky!
Yucky.
Yucky green. But make it kind of fun and interesting.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely.
That's what I'm going to do. That's a warning to my grandkids. Okay. Now, my daughter loves to eat really good food. I mean, she'll make herself a salad with the greens, and then she cuts up an apple in it. She cuts up an avocado. And I mean, she's just increasingly doing that. And she made dinner the other night that was amazing. And she said, it was a little bit of this, and that. It was all natural foods. And she didn't say that. She just said, it was just, she had some fish. She had, mostly vegetables. And a little bit of pasta for the kids to add in just to make them happy. But it was just so good.
Yeah.
And she's, I'm so proud of her that she's doing this because she's a scientist at heart and in the brain. She's a pharmacist. My son-in-law is a doctor of pharmacology. He was one of her professors. And, love story there. But she's looking at it from the viewpoint of better health, feeling better.
Right.
And she's been an influence with me, too, in that way.
Oh, that's great.
I think if you get the kids started early, and they're not used to all the processed foods, and this is the type of food they're growing with, they wouldn't even question it.
I know.
That's right.
Yeah, it's true.
True. Now, we've got just a minute or two left, but I wanted to make sure you're talking about what you think is packaged food, but it's not, okay? So this is a new thing that, because of demand, Jo is putting together, and she's going to make it available. You probably can get it through your website.
Not yet, but eventually?
Soon.
Yeah,
and it's interesting. What have you got in this one, and what's in that one, real quick?
Okay, so this is chocolate mint kale chips.
Okay.
That one sounds really good to me.
Okay, thank you.
This one is granola.
This is a granola, vanilla, cinnamon, coconut. There's maple syrup, dried fruit. There's sprouted buckwheat, and buckwheat has 5 grams, I think it's 5 or 4 grams of protein and 5 or 4 grams of fiber. I like to put the buckwheat in there. And there's pecans and pumpkin seeds, all kinds of good things. But you could just put it with your yogurt
or
do whatever you want, with it. As far as that, you can snack on it. It's really great.
Nice.
Yeah. So.
Okay, so we got the countdown going here.
Okay.
First of all, Jo, thank you so much.
Absolutely. Thank you.
We're going to stay here and eat more.
We have all of that to finish.
Yes, we do.
What I want to also say is I want to thank our sponsors for being there for us. And I also like to end the show with a quote or two, and I got a couple of them here tonight. It's not a short-term diet. It's a long-term lifestyle change.
And also, never eat ingredients you can't pronounce, except quinoa. Eat quinoa.
Love it.
Thank you again so much. This has been a great show. Hope you've enjoyed it. Remember to check out our website, Facebook page, and we will see you again on From This Corner TV. Bye-bye.